Just arrived at the Challow Paramotor Club field. Nil wind conditions, look at the flag. Well, very, very low wind. Fog, 7 o'clock in the morning, 7 degrees centigrade. So why am I here if this is all to do with the Ashdown House? Well, the fact is that Ashdown House is 8 miles as the crow flies in that direction. And this is going to be an ideal opportunity to take off, fly above it, and then I think I might just get a chance to actually look inside it. But just look at the lovely scenery here, beautiful with low fog. So quick flight briefing. So what's the plan then, Tone?
Okay, so this is us at Grove. Yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to fly towards Ashdown House, which is one of our
turning
waypoints.
Yeah.
So that's near Ashbury.
Yeah.
Okay. We're then going to fly towards Membury and wave at
Simon
if we do our usual left-hand circuit takeoff.
Yeah.
If you can't put a left-hand circuit, turn around to the right and get yourself over out the way,
yeah,
and then you can change to a left-hand circuit when it's safe to do so. I'm not expecting anybody to come and land unless Clive turns up. So if we then travel towards the aerial high point, which is our usual marker on the ridgeway.
So, yeah, so we're looking at what, 1500 to 2000 foot
altitude?
Yeah,
we want to be at 1500 feet by the time we're on top of the ridge to give us our 500 clearance on the ridgeway.
Yeah.
And then we'll fly from 1500 to 2000 feet. We don't want to go too high because it'll be too cold up there.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So then our first waypoint then will be Ashdown.
So Ashdown, and then
Membury.
If you want to, from Ashdown, if you want to head towards the M4 and then down to Membury, we can probably take in a couple of sites along the way.
Yeah, okay. And this hopefully will give you an hour and a half to 2 hours flying, and that'll put you up to 100 hours of airborne time, wouldn't it?
I'm hoping to get to 100 hours. Yeah.
Well done, Tone, that's good.
Yeah, that's about 180 flights. Though.
Yeah, well done, yeah, well done. We've been joined at the field by no other than Clive Bunce himself, and Clive produces the Bulldog paramotor unit, and I'm quite privileged to be flying with Clive. He's a very highly respected paramotor instructor also. For those of you that are in the paramotor scene in the UK, you probably have heard of Clive Bunce. Morning, Clive.
Morning, mate.
Looking forward to a good flight.
I am. Where are we going?
We're heading out to Ridgeway, then across to Ashdown, tracking over to Membury. Looks like we're landing out at Membury.
Okay.
And then stay there for a cup of coffee and a chat, probably, and then back here.
Sounds good. Well, it's good weather for it.
Yeah.
Good day. Visibility looks cracking. So it should be enjoyable.
Well then, see you in the sky. Well, I'm off the ground now. Just waiting for one other pilot to launch, and then we'll be on our way on our cross-country flight. Looks like either Tony, I can't tell which one it is. Well, if one other pilot is up now anyway, and whilst I'm waiting for the last pilot to launch, I'm just circling around, maintaining altitude before we set off on our journey across to Ashdown. Well, all the pilots are now airborne. Tony just took off. Clive's in front of me, making our way on our planned journey to the Ridgeway up by Sparshot Firs, where we then divert in a westerly direction across Effington and on to Ashdown House itself. We're up on the high ground now, just cruising along by the ridgeway, 1850 feet AMSL, on our course heading towards Ashdown House. Big thumbs up on the suit. The suit's nice and warm. I've got not been any cold at all. When I launched today, it was 7 degrees centigrade. So there is Ashdown House. In front of us now, the woods and the estate. Well, that's Ashdown House now. I'm coasting on Robert Park Hill. About 1800 feet AMSL. A beautiful estate, a lovely house, the Gold's House. I was very fortunate enough to be able to visit and look inside Ashdown House recently. So I'll put some video clips of that in now for you to watch. First we'll have a little flyby, fly over the house and have a look at the gardens beyond.
Winter Queen.
She doesn't wear them because they're supposed to be unlucky. But one of the ropes of pearls, there's only six now, one of the ropes of pearls was buried with his uncle.
Head of the household cavalry.
He was.
Prince Rupert.
Prince Rupert to the Rhine. Yeah. The only one that she was shot and killed.
When this house was built, these hundreds of years ago, people would come up here to see where they could see the deer, and see where they could go hunting to go and shoot the deer.
Beautiful, isn't it?
away. It's just a box hedge to make it look good. Sorry, Sandy. If he was videoing.
You got video, I think you missed both files. Huh? I'm video, I'm not sure.
I'm back on old familiar territory now. We're heading back to land at Membury, which is near the M4. This is the place where I first learnt to fly paramotors. Meet up with Simon and probably Colin. Landed safely at Membury, just slip on the wet grass, but we're here. And there's Simon.
Hello.
There's Tony. Simon Westmore from the Paramotor Club. And Simon, you're going to be on the One Show soon, aren't you?
Next week. No, not next week.
And we're not supposed to say that
filming
to them.
Filming next week.
Can I say that to them?
Yeah, I think
so. Oh, okay.
But, yeah, but it's filming next week, so yeah, probably
brilliant.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks. Yeah. Conditions are very, well, we've got a nice breeze now, haven't we? Hopefully we'll get
yeah,
a good.
We'll just
hopefully get a better takeoff.
Hopefully we'll get a better takeoff. Yeah. This is the training field at Membury. Fond memories of this place. Done my first flight here. Well, we're up again now. On our way heading back to the Chalo Club now. Clive's going to try and do some close proximity flying. He's a very skilled pilot. He's asked me to fly in a straight line. There's no control inputs and he'll do all the hard work. Hopefully we should get some good close-ups of a paramotor in flight. Clive, flying the paramotor about 1700 feet above mean sea level at the moment, over the high downs. Now heading back to a landing at Chalo Paramotor Club. I derobed, the flight suit worked absolutely fantastic. So Lee, thank you for giving that to me, that was tremendous. That's going to really have me set up for winter paramotoring now. Landed back at Chalo. Quite a good landing, into the wind. Stood it up. Tony, you done your 100th hour?
That's it, yeah.
Well done, mate.
I just want to say on the video, thanks to Simon Westmore letting us land out at his facility.
That was nice. We flew over and landed at Membury. Met Simon and Colin.
Yep, see all the lads training.
Yeah, that was good, wasn't it?
Didn't embarrass ourselves too much.
No, not at all. And what was you about to say, Clive? You got some yoghurt on your face?
No, it's all gone there.
Thanks for accompanying us on this mission, Clive.
That
was
right.
A very worthwhile adventure, wasn't it?
Nice flight this morning.
Yeah, very nice.
Makes it worthwhile.
And there it is, the Bulldog paramotor. Clive tells me that the Bulldog is the company. It's all British, built very near to where I live. And the model that is the Spirit. So this is the Bulldog Spirit in all its glory. The prop's been taken off now and it can be broken down, packed away and transported in the back of the car very easily.